What's up, everyone? I'm Haletta Alamu, and welcome to another episode of the DNA Download, where we explain the science of genetics so you can live in the know. Whenever I hear people talk about getting their DNA tested, one topic that almost always comes up is how much of their DNA comes from Neanderthals. That's right, you heard me, Neanderthals, not Neanderthals. Here to help explain more about our ancient ancestors is Alex Langston from 23andMe's customer care team. Alex, thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so right off the bat, I've been told it's pronounced Neanderthal, but others say Neanderthal. Which one is right?
That depends. How good is your German?
My German.
Yeah, so Neanderthals are actually named after the Neander Valley in Germany where their bones were first discovered.
Oh.
Tal is the German word for valley.
Interesting. So then who were the Neanderthals?
Neanderthals were a species of ancient humans who interbred with modern humans before going extinct around 40,000 years ago.
I didn't realize there was more than one species of humans.
Yes, so millions of years ago, there were actually several species of humans, but we are the only species who survived to today. We call ourselves modern humans, or Homo sapiens, which literally translates to wise man.
Well, we're a humble bunch, aren't we? So what do we know about the Neanderthals?
Well, they lived in Europe and Asia, and compared to modern humans, they had wider bodies, shorter arms and legs, and heavy brow ridges. But unlike the classic caveman stereotype, Neanderthals were actually a lot like us.
Oh, how so?
Well, evidence suggests they used medicinal plants to relieve pain. They also constructed buildings, created tools, art, and jewelry, and exhibited complex social behaviors.
Yep, that sounds like us. And what did Neanderthals have to do with us now?
Well, the short answer is they're family. They're our closest evolutionary relatives. And people who have Neanderthal DNA have a Neanderthal ancestor, a grandparent to the 2000th degree.
Wow, so there's a little Neanderthal in all of us?
Well, not all of us, but a lot of us. Huh. So tens of thousands of years ago, some of our modern human ancestors explored beyond Africa, where they met their Neanderthal neighbors and mated with them, probably in the Middle East or Europe. So while many people can trace about 1 to 2% of their DNA back to Neanderthals, the populations that stayed behind in sub-Saharan Africa probably never met the Neanderthals. So their modern descendants have essentially no Neanderthal DNA.
That is so cool. So how does Neanderthal DNA affect us today?
Well, Neanderthal DNA can contribute to traits like your height, or whether or not you have back hair, or even a tendency to sneeze after you eat dark chocolate.
Sneezing? I mean, who knew dark chocolate could be so powerful, or that our connection to it could run so deep? I love it. Thanks for stopping by, Alex, and the next time somebody talks about how much of our DNA comes from Neanderthals, I'll be ready. See you next time on the DNA Download.